Hey everybody, Economic Ninja here. I hope you're doing great. I've got some big news to tell you. And the reason why it's big news, because it might not affect you in your country, but I believe that we are going to see a trend here very shortly. And that is large-scale protests when it comes to dock workers or anyone involved in the supply chain. See, in the last year, if you haven't been noticing, now I know you guys have been noticing because my subscribers are awesome, inflation is getting bad and it is going to get worse. That is true. That is not fear, uncertainty, and doubt. It is certainty because the Federal Reserve keeps printing money like madmen. And actually, if you're not in America, your central bank's doing the exact same too. So we're all in the same boat. How awesome is that? I know. How do you smile when all this crap's going down? It's because we're prepared and not scared. All right, so let's dive into this. I'm gonna bring you this story. We can keep the notes down. All right, cool. This is about a potential dock worker strike that could unleash a super meltdown, quote unquote, at a German port of Hamburg. Now, just so you guys know, the German port at Hamburg is about the 15th in size globally, the 15th largest globally. So a lot of you would be like, well, so what, who cares? I want you to understand that if this, and we're gonna talk specifically about this scenario, but remember, I believe there's gonna be a contagion effect, and we're gonna talk about that in a little bit. It says right now, a German report came out, a newspaper, saying that congestion in Hamburg is worsening and container ships have to wait 2 weeks before entering the port. The quote was saying, the waiting times are unsatisfactory and for a shipping company. And this was, I'm not even gonna try and pronounce that name. My German's not that good. Duh. All right. Hamburg, all right, let's try it. For all of my awesome subscribers from Germany, go ahead and let me know how I do right here. Hamburg Hafen und Logistik. Boy, that's just, I'm gonna stop. A top European port and transport authority company, logistics company, said the reason for increasing congestion is a slowdown in the processing of containers, especially imports from the Far East, not being transported fast enough by truck and train. You know, we've seen this before, and I'm going to bring this, give you guys a little bit of light of what's going on. We saw this before at the Port of Los Angeles, and I think it's very important to understand the issues that that caused. Now, I blame California's awesome sarcasm, sense it, politics when it came to the DEF systems and trucks, and only specific trucks could offload those shipping containers, you know, out of the port, and it just caused a big mess, right? But what happened is that continued down the supply chain all the way to the stores, the mom and pop stores even, back in the Midwest, right? So a small issue became larger and larger, and it just spread, right? Well, now we're talking about strikes that are going on. And you know what? Let me ask, there was something else I had here. Let's see here. It says right here that the timing of the process strike by dock workers comes as consumer prices in Europe's largest economy surged 8.7% year over year last month. It was the highest since the start of the monthly statistics in 1963. That is absolutely unbelievable, right? And we're starting to see bigger and bigger numbers like that coming out. And it's really interesting because if you think about it, you know, these 50-year cycles, and now we're talking about even a larger one, keep popping out. And I talked to you about these cycles in economics, where the economic cycles every 7 to 10 years, but larger ones sit at 50 years and 100 years, right? We're also sitting at that 50-year mark where we have not seen the bond market correct at the same time as the stock market in the last 50 years, right? And even though a lot of people think we're out of the woods, I still have a feeling we got some more pain going over the next 6 months. But it's really impressive to me of what's going on. Well, all of that stress, right, of the world trying to put stress on, let's say that country putting stress on its dock workers, hey, you've got to get things going faster. And the dock workers are going, hey, we don't have enough help. We need more tools, better equipment, you know, so on and so forth. What happens is that pressure builds up and finally they go, look, heck with this, we're going to strike. That would be devastating, right? Even at the 15th largest port in the country, or I'm sorry, the world, that would be bad. Because what happens is as they're striking, they're having chaos, then the next port down the road needs to take up some kind of slack, and they're already not set up for it. Ports around the world right now are feeling stress. And even I just heard the other day from somebody that actually knows somebody down in the port of LA, and they said what they're doing is they're having such extreme stress. The ships have decided that are coming in from other countries into the port, they know that they're going to be sitting docked. So what they do is to save money, they're idling down or they're slowing their motors and they're just cruising through the ocean, planning that, hey, look, rather than steam full ahead to the port, let's just cruise and try and save fuel and just keep on our way to the port, knowing that I'd rather just get there longer, take longer to get there than sit there idle and just floating. And so they're already trying to plan, and it's just causing more and more pressure, right? Well, the same thing goes for anyone in the, not the service industry, but the logistics industry. The more pressure it happens and your pay is not going up, your hours are getting worse, you know, there's more and more stress, it's going to drive people to strike. And that is a really, really bad thing. Now, what can you do to prepare for that? Well, honestly, anytime there's pressure in any industry, right, and there's a strike involved, it does cause delays and cost increase, right? When we're talking about global things that are happening right now, that is going to cause more and more price increases. So what do? You go and buy more stuff. You don't go buy stuff that you can't, you know, use or you don't need, but you need to go think right now. Like, I can't, it's almost like I'm a brokered record, and it really does suck because it's like, you know what the prices are going to be tomorrow. As of right now, until monetary policy changes or fiscal policy on the government side, we are headed for much higher inflation worldwide. And the US is taking the brunt of it. So I really encourage you to please think about those necessities right now. Think ahead, buy what you need, and then let's go crush it, because as people that don't prepare for this get caught with it, I'm telling you, there's going to be opportunities. Things are going to be on sale, and we're already starting to see it. Inventory is stacking up all over the country right now as they offloaded those ships finally, and people simply don't have the money to buy those fancy TVs anymore because they're paying more money to drive their big trucks. They're paying more money to go to the grocery store. All right, guys, that being said, I thank you so much for watching The Economic Ninja. Is out.